Gallbladder surgery is often recommended if a patient has had a significant and severe case of cholecystitis. If they've had a bout of abdominal pain that's caused them to go to the emergency room, if they've had an elevated white count, high fevers, this suggests a more severe form of gallbladder disease. This is often enough to warrant surgical intervention, and a surgeon will consult with the patient to discuss the benefits and risks of doing surgery. If, however, the abdominal pain is not so severe and the patient wishes a short trial of conservative management, they may try to go on a low-fat or non-fat diet in the hopes of quieting any gallbladder discomfort down. Unfortunately, this only tends to be partially successful, and patients will often come to realization that surgery is the only real cure for gallbladder disease. Gallbladder surgery today is often performed laparoscopically. If performed laparoscopically, surgeons are successful that way 95% of the time. The surgery itself will then be done as an outpatient setting where the patient will go home the same day that surgery is performed. The surgery is performed by putting a small camera through the belly button and having the gallbladder dissected off the gallbladder bed and removed through the umbilical port. Patients will be discharged home on a low-fat diet for the first 1 to 2 days. However, shortly after that, the patient can start to resume normal food. Patients will then recover at home and are often back to work within a week. Patients will also then follow up with their surgeon 1 to 2 weeks after the procedure to review instructions, examine the incisions, and review any pertinent pathology.